Hello students, this is now last video lecture from wave particle duality. Quantum mechanics two, as I told you, two parts are there, wave particle duality and wave equation. So first part now today we are going to complete wave particle duality. Some numericals based on this chapter we are going to study now. So first of all try to understand the formulas, all the formulas I have listed out here. So one by one let us see the formulas. First formula, if you see, E is equal to h nu. If you are asked to find out energy of photon, see, it is photon, it is not proton. So if you are asked to find out energy of photon, then you have to use this formula, E is equal to h nu, and nu is frequency, so it is hc by lambda. Then second one is Einstein's mass energy relation is equal to mc square. Then third one is again the basic formula, velocity is equal to frequency into lambda, nu lambda. Then E is equal to, actually kinetic energy is 1/2 mv square, and E 1/2 mv square is nothing but what? P square by 2m, if you multiply and divide by m, that we studied in the last video lectures. So 1/2 mv square means P square by 2m. So energy is also given by what? P square by 2m. So if you know momentum, you can find out energy by using this relation also, right? The next is expression of lambdas. Now all these formulas are very 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 important. So if you see, first lambda is equal to h by p, p means momentum, so it is h by mv, right? Then lambda we studied in terms of energy, so lambda is equal to h upon under root twice me. In terms of potential, it is h upon, if it is charged particle, if you are asked to find out wavelength of any charged particle, electron, proton or alpha particle, any potential is given, then you can use this formula, h upon under root twice me into v. So try to understand the meanings of the symbols. M is mass of particle. Whatever particle would be given in the numerical, the mass of that particle you have to take. Suppose electron, lambda of electron is asked, then electron's mass you have to take. If lambda of proton is asked, then mass of proton you have to take. So mass of respective particle you have to take. Okay. So these are the four formulas. Then if specifically lambda of electron is asked, then actually we have done these calculations, and by means we have put value of h, mass of electron, value of charge of electron, then we got this value 12.27 upon under root v. So you can remember this value, and you can use this direct formula if lambda of electron is asked. Similarly, if lambda of proton is asked, actually we have found the value, but if you don't remember, then we can use this formula there, and in that formula we have to use mass of proton. Right, charge is same actually. So for electron you remember this formula, for proton you can use this one, and you can put mass of proton over there. So all these are the formulas based on wavelength of, means De-Broglie's wavelength. Now the second part from this chapter is Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, and this is the formula: uncertainty in position delta x into uncertainty in momentum delta p is always equal to h, right? So for solving numericals we take this as h. It is actually greater than or equal to h, greater than or equal to h upon 2 pi or h upon 4 pi, but for solving numericals we take the value as h. Okay, so p delta p we can write momentum m into delta v, so delta p we can write m into delta v, so this formula becomes this one, right? Delta x uncertainty in position, delta p uncertainty in momentum, delta v uncertainty in velocity. What you have to remember here, when you use this formula, lambda is equal to h upon under root twice me, this energy should be always, it should be in joule. Whenever we use any formula of energy, energy should be in what? Joule. So sometimes suppose energy is given in electron volt. First you have to convert that energy into joule. How to convert it into joule? You have to multiply the energy by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Right, charge, so the energy will be converted into joule. Sometimes you will be asked to find out energy, means you will be given lambda, you will be given m, and you will be asked to find out what energy, but you will be asked energy to find energy in electron hole. So by using this formula you will get energy in joule, then you have to convert it into what? Electron hole. So when you want to convert it into electron hole, you have to divide whatever value you will get here, that value you have to divide by what? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. So energy, convert energy into joule, you have to multiply by this value. If you want to convert it in electron volt, you have to divide it by this one. So this thing you have to remember. This is very, very, very important. Okay. Again here, when you use Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, delta x, this should be in meter. If it is in centimeter, angstrom, you have to convert it into what? Meter. So remember these things. Convergence, again, 1 angstrom and it is equal to 10 to minus 8 centimeter is equal to 10 to minus 10 meter. 1 electron volt is equal to this one, right? So same, I have explained over here. Same thing I have written here. Then this is very important. Sometimes you are asked to find out what? Lambda of alpha particle. If lambda of electron is asked, then you have to put mass of electron. If lambda of proton is asked, then you have to put mass of proton. And those values would be given actually. Means these values. Value of H, mass of electron, mass of proton, value of E. That would be given to you in the question paper. There is no need to remember these values. But if you are asked to find out lambda of alpha particle, mass of alpha particle will not be given to you. In that case, you must know alpha particle is nothing but what? 2 protons and 2 neutrons. So mass of alpha particle is equal to 4 into mass of proton, because mass of proton and neutron is same. So it is 4 into mass of proton. So mass of alpha particle, remember, it is 4 into mass of proton. Similarly, charge of alpha particle. Now charge of alpha particle, neutron is neutral, no charge is there. So charge of alpha particle is nothing but what? 2 into charge of proton. Charge we denote by E or Q. Here we have denoted charge by Q. Okay. Here we have denoted charge by E. So charge, remember, mass of alpha particle is equal to 4 into mass of proton, and charge of alpha particle is equal to 2 into charge of proton. So this thing you have to remember. Okay. So these are the formulas based on this chapter. Now let us see the numericals, some numericals one by one. You have to practice these numericals in home. So see the first numerical. De-Broglie's wavelength of electron beam is given here. So De-Broglie's wavelength means lambda is given to you. Calculate momentum of electron and energy of electron in electron hole. See, specifically it is asked energy of electron in electron hole. So lambda is given to you. You are asked to find out momentum and energy. So simple formula, lambda is equal to H by P. Value of H, you know, this one is value of H, and you can find out here momentum. So once you know momentum, you can find out energy. This formula, you know, A is equal to P square by 2m. If you do the put the values, if you do the calculations, you will get this value. But here you will get this value in joule, right? This energy you will get in joule. See, here we got it. And then we have divided it by 1.6 into 10 to minus 19 to convert it into electron volt. So this thing you have to remember here. Okay. When you use the energy formula, energy should be in joule. If you are asked to find out in electron volt, you have to divide it by 1.6 into 10 to minus 19. So this is in electron volt. Now see, second, find de Broglie's wavelength of 10 kilo electron volt electron. So you must know here, you should be able to identify what is given here. 10 kilo electron volt, that means energy. So energy is given 10 kilo electron volt. Convert this into electron volt first. Kilo to electron volt, so it is 10 raised to 3. So 10 into 10 raised to 3 electron volt. Now electron volt to joule, we have to convert it into joule because we have to use this formula, and in this formula energy should be in joule. So to convert it into joule, we have to multiply it by this, right? So then now this energy is in joule. And then you can use this formula. Lambda is equal to H upon under root twice ME. So you will get the value of lambda in meter. Now same example, find De-Broglie's wavelength of 10 kilo electron volt neutron. See, here it was 10 kilo electron electron, and now here it is neutron. So same thing you have to do, only you have to put what here? Mass of neutron, not mass of electron. Now here you have to use the same example is there. You have to use mass of neutron. Okay. Now see, de Broglie's wavelength and velocity of alpha particle. Now see here, alpha particle of 1 kilo electron volt. Again, energy is given here. Energy is given, kilo to electron volt converted first, 10 raised to 3, then electron volt to joule converted. Right, so this energy is in joule now. And then you have to use this formula, lambda of alpha particle. You are asked to find out lambda of alpha particle. So, formula of lambda in terms of energy you have to use, because energy is given here. But here you have to use now what? Mass of alpha particle. And mass of alpha particle is nothing but what? 4 into mass of proton. So this is 4 into, this is mass of proton. So these things are important here, right? So in this way you will find lambda of alpha particle, and then velocity you have to find, right? Velocity. So velocity you can find by using this one again. Lambda is equal to h by p. P is nothing but mv. So h upon mv. Again you have to use here what? Mass of alpha particle. And mass of alpha particle again is nothing but what? 4 into mass of proton. Here it is written, 4 into mass of proton. So in this way you can find out value of velocity. Okay. I'm going to explain here only which formula you have to use. Huh? Try to understand the concept. You can practice these numericals in home after this video lecture. Now see another type of example. Now here, electron is accelerated through 10 kilovolt. Kilovolt means potential is given now, it's not energy. So 10 kilovolt is potential. Calculate de Broglie's wavelength and momentum of electron. So potential is 10 kilovolt, convert it into volt. Kilo means 10 raised to 3. You are asked to find out lambda and p. Now this is electron, so you are asked to find out wavelength of electron, and potential is given to you. So this formula, you know, direct formula you can write here. Lambda of electron is nothing but what? 12.27 upon under root v. But remember, the value would be in angstrom, right? If you use this formula, it would be in angstrom. So you will get lambda of electron in angstrom. If you want to convert it in meter, just multiply it by 10 raised to minus 10 meter. Right, so this is lambda, and then you have to find momentum. So simple formula, lambda is equal to h by p. So p you have to find out here, that is momentum. Okay, now same example, but see, de Broglie's wavelength of 10 kilovolt proton. So again here potential is given, 10 kilovolt proton. So potential is given, 10 kilovolt, convert it into volt, means kilo 10 raised to 3, and this 10 raised to 4 volt. Now you are asked to find out proton. Potential is given, so you have to use this formula. Lambda is equal to h upon under root twice me into v in terms of potential. Formula in terms of what? Potential. Now if you remember, actually for proton we calculated this, means we have done these calculations and we have found the value 0.286 upon under root v as like electron. But if you don't remember it, just use this formula. And here you write mass of proton, charge of proton, same charge of electron. So you can find out lambda of proton. Okay, so just give attention ki which particle's energy or which particle's wavelength you have to find. So mass of that respective particle you have to put in the formula. At least we first formula was lambda of photon, energy of photon. So if photon particle is there, then you have to use this formula, E is equal to h nu. For photon you have to use this one, right? So you have to find lambda of photon as well as lambda of electron. So how to find out lambda of photon? Now you have to use E is equal to h nu. Nu is hc by lambda, so E is equal to hc by lambda, and here you will get lambda of photon. So just remember, for photon you will not use this formula. For photon you have to use E is equal to hc by lambda. So here you will get lambda of photon, and by using the same, actually the conventional formula, you can find out here lambda of electron. Again the energies are in electron volt, you have to convert it into joule. So in this way you will find what? Lambda of electron, and then compare these two. So here mass of proton would be there, and similarly you will write the same formula for lambda of alpha particle, h upon s twice, same formula, but here what? Mass of alpha particle. Here you will write charge of alpha particle and then potential. So for proton it is same now, but for alpha particle, you know, mass of alpha particle is nothing but what? 4 into mass of proton, and charge of alpha particle is 2 into charge of proton, right? Now see, for proton actually we replace E by Q here. Mass of proton, charge of proton. And mass of alpha particle is 4 into mass of proton, charge of alpha particle is 2 into charge of proton. So, and then you can take the ratio of these two. So you will, if you take the ratios, all the thing, the things get cancelled, and you will get only root of 16, root of, root of 8, and it is 2 root. Okay, so just practice these numericals in home so that you will better understand it. Now the next is calculate de Broglie's wavelength of proton. You have to find what? Wavelength of proton moving with velocity of 1% of velocity of light. That means this proton particle is moving with velocity 1% of velocity of light. Okay. So you have to find lambda of proton. So we'll use mass of proton here, this one. Then velocity of proton, it is given as what? 1% of velocity of light. So 1 by 100 into velocity of light, 3 into 10 raised to 8. So this is 1% of velocity of light. Got it all of you? If it is given 2% of velocity of light, it would be what then? 2 upon 100 into 3 velocity of light. So this is nothing but 1% of velocity of light. And then simple formula, lambda is equal to velocity is given. So you have to use lambda in terms of velocity, h upon mv. You can find out lambda of proton here. Okay, now let us see some examples based on now Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. This formula you know, Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, delta x delta p is equal to h. Okay, so see, assume that uncertainty in location of particle is equal to its de Broglie's wavelength. See what is given here. Uncertainty in location of particle means delta x is equal to its de Broglie's wavelength is equal to its de Broglie's wavelength means lambda. So what is given actually here? Delta x uncertainty in location is equal to lambda. Show that uncertainty in velocity means delta v is equal to its velocity. So you have to show this one. Use simple solution is there. You write Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, delta x delta p is equal to h. For delta p you can write m into delta v. Momentum is mv na? So delta p is m into delta v is equal to h. So delta v you have to show. So write this equation in terms of delta v. So delta v becomes equal to what? H upon delta x and m on this side. Okay, so delta v is equal to, now delta x is given here. Delta x is given what here? Lambda. So we can put delta x is equal to lambda. So h upon lambda into m. Now lambda is equal to h by mv. So v is equal to h upon lambda into m. So if you put this value, means h upon lambda into m, and this is nothing but what? Velocity. So delta v is equal to v. Okay. Now see this one more simple example. An electron is bounded by a potential box of infinite height having width 2.5 angstrom minute. Calculate minimum uncertainty in its velocity. So see actually what is given here. An electron is bounded by a potential box. Means electron is inside this box. Suppose a box is there. An electron is inside this box. Whose width is what? 2.5 angstrom minute. So electron is somewhere inside this box. Whose width is 2.5 angstrom minute. So uncertainty in position of electron is nothing but what? 2.5 angstrom minute. So uncertainty in position is given here, 2.5 angstrom minute. Got it all of you? Meaning of this sentence. So delta x is given 2.5 angstrom minute, but you know it should be in what? When you use this formula, delta x should be in meter. So convert this in meter. Calculate uncertainty in its velocity. Delta v you have to find. So simple formula, delta x into delta p is equal to h. For delta p you can write m into delta v. And you can find out delta v. Now here mass of what now here? Electron, because electron is given here. So you have to put mass of electron over here. So this value will get uncertainty in velocity. Right. Now next is, electron has speed of 600 meter per second. So velocity is given 600 meter per second. Measured with an accuracy of 0.005%. means the speed is measured with an accuracy of 0.005%. What is the meaning of this sentence? Speed is measured accurately up to 0.005% means uncertainty in the measurement of speed is nothing but what? 0.005%. 0.005% of velocity. That is the uncertainty in the measurement of speed. So velocity is given 6 centimeter per second. Uncertainty in the measurement of velocity. So delta V. It is 0.005% of velocity. So 0.005% means 0.005 upon 100 into velocity 600. So this is nothing but uncertainty in velocity. And then you can use this formula to find out delta X. Okay. Then this one is simple example. You can practice it in home. Now see the next one, this one. Okay. Electron is accelerated by potential of 1 kilovolt. So potential is given here, 1 kilovolt. It is nothing but 10 raised to 3 volt. Its position and momentum are measured simultaneously. If its position is located within 1 angstrom minute. So what is given here? Position is located within 1 angstrom minute. That means the electron is inside the box having width 1 angstrom minute. So uncertainty in position is given. Delta X is equal to 1 angstrom minute. Convert it into meter. 10 raised to minus 10 meter. Find percentage of uncertainty in its momentum. So what you have to find here? Percentage of uncertainty in momentum means suppose uncertainty is delta P. That uncertainty it is uncertainty in measurement of momentum when the momentum would be P. So when particle's momentum is P, uncertainty in the measurement of that momentum is nothing but delta P. What is percentage? Delta P upon P into 100. So this is the meaning of percentage of uncertainty in momentum. You have to find this. So see, suppose you have to find this one. That means you have to find first delta P. You have to find P. So let us find first P. To find P, we can use which formula? Yes, lambda is equal to H by P. This formula we can use. But for that, we don't know lambda of electron. So you have to first find lambda of electron. And if potential is given, you can use formula of lambda of electron as what? 12.27 upon under root V. And it would be an angstrom minute. So this you will get, but this is an angstrom minute. Convert this into meter, 10 raised to minus 10. So this is lambda of electron. And now you can use this lambda is equal to H by P. So you can put value of lambda over here. You can find out P. Right? P momentum, mass into velocity. So kg, mass, velocity meter per second. So this is momentum. So P you found here. Now we have to find what? Delta P. So for delta P we use uncertainty principle. Delta X into delta P is equal to H. So delta P is equal to H upon delta X. Value of H Planck's constant and delta X is uncertainty in position. So delta P you will find. Now by using these two you can find out percentage of uncertainty in momentum. So delta P upon P into 100. Okay, so these are the numericals, all types of numericals we have covered here. Just practice these numericals in home. Write down all these numericals in your assignment notebook. Try to solve of your own. If you are not able to do it, then only see the solution. Okay.